Good morning students. Today we are going to learn about phases of the moon. In the last class we learned about the conditions on the moon and some landings on the moon. So today we are going to learn about the different phases of the moon. So first of all, open your books on page number 97. And we are going to read the topic phases of the moon. So get ready with your pencils to underline the important lines. And read with me. Phases of the moon. The moon revolves around the earth every 27.3 days. So one revolution of moon is for 27.3 days. So one revolution of moon is equal to 27.3 days. It also rotates on its own axis. Just like earth, it also rotates on its own axis. The time periods of rotation and revolution of the moon are almost the same. So, the time taken by the moon to take one rotation and one revolution, it is both the almost the same. Thus, the same side of the moon is always facing the earth. This is why we always only see just one side of the moon. The part of the moon that faces the sun is lit up by the sun. So, the part of the moon that faces the sun is lit up by the sun. Different positions of the moon are illuminated by the sun at different times during its rotation. So, when the moon is rotating, it changes its position a little bit. So, different portions of the moon are illuminated or lightened up at different time periods during its rotation. These illuminated portions appear to change shape when viewed from the earth. So when we look at the moon from the earth, sometimes we see no moon at all, sometimes we see a full moon, sometimes we see half moon, and sometimes we see very small or very big portion of the moon, but not the complete moon. These changing shapes of the moon are known as the phases of moon. So what we have learned is the phases of moon. So one revolution of moon takes place in 27.3 days. And it also rotates on its own axis. And also the time period taken by the moon to complete one revolution and one rotation is almost the same. That is the reason why we always see only one side of the moon. That is always the same side of the moon is facing the earth. So the side of the moon that faces the sun is lit up by the sun. And different portions at different times. This means that different portions are lit up at different times during its rotation. And because of this, it changes shape when we view it from the earth. When we look at it, it looks like the moon is changing its shape when it is not. It is just rotating and different portions are getting lights at different times during its rotation. So, these changing shapes of the moon are known as phases of moon. So, now actually we are going to learn about the different phases of moon. New moon. In this phase, the illuminated side of the moon is away from the earth. So, here we can see the new moon. Here, the illuminated side, that is the side facing the sun, is away from the earth. So, the side of the moon facing the earth receives no sunlight and hence cannot be seen from the earth. This phase is known is called the new moon. So, the side of the moon that faces the earth is not receiving any sunlight. So, we cannot see it from the earth. We don't see anything. That is why it is dark. Now, the crescent moon. In this phase, a small portion of the illuminated side of the moon is facing towards the earth. So, here you can see that a very small illuminated side is facing towards the earth because the other portion of the illuminated side is not facing the earth. So, a small portion of the moon can only be seen from the earth. So it is called a crescent because it is in the shape of a crescent. Half moon. When half portion of the illuminated side of the moon is facing towards the earth, we can see a half of the moon from the earth. It is called half moon. So when we can see only the half side, half portion of the illuminated side of the earth, it is known as half moon. So we can only see half side of the illuminated part of the moon from the earth. So it is called half moon. Now here it is given about blue moon in the Wonder Box. If two full moons appear in the same month, the second moon is called the blue moon, but it is not blue in color. So very rarely this happens, a blue moon. That is, if two full moons, two complete full moons are seen in a month, the second moon is known as blue moon and not the full moon. But it is not blue in color, it is of the same color as the moon, it shines the same way. Now let's go to next page, page number 98, gibbous moon. When a large portion of the illuminated side of the moon is facing towards the earth, we can see a large portion of the moon from the earth. So when a large portion or this portion of the illuminated side of the moon is facing towards the earth, it can be seen from the earth. So it is known as gibbous moon. Full moon is when the entire portion of the illuminated side of the moon faces towards the earth, we can see the perfectly round moon. Because this side is facing the sun also, so the full moon, that is the full side, complete side of the illuminated part, can be seen from the earth. So it is known as a full moon. The phases of the moon reverse after the full moon. The time period between two full moons is about 29.5 days. So this process keeps on repeating. And the time period between two full moons is 29.5 days. So the phases of moon are new moon, crescent moon, half moon, gibbous moon and full moon. So this is your topic for today that we have done. You have to revise it, and your homework is that you have to revise the chapter that we have done so far and do this exercise, that is track your process exercise in your books only, and you have to do the questions from your PPT in your notebook in beautiful handwriting. Thank you, and remember to revise the chapter.